The wonders of BuzzFeed feminists, the ass cancer of the internet. So today, guys, I'm gonna be reacting to what is this? 36 questions women have for men. But I'm pretty, yeah, I was gonna say this is a BuzzFeed video, and they're all super fucking stupid. So I've seen this before. I really have. I mean, it was all over the internet at one point. But let's react to it. Let's do it. God, so I'm gonna be answering them because I'm a man. I have a bulgy between thoused legs. So
how does it feel to be the same sex as Donald Trump?
I don't know. How does it? That's such a dumb question because I was just saying, how does it feel to be the same sex as someone I politically disagree with? It's just dumb. Like,
why do you hate rom-coms? Or do you just feel like you need to hate them?
Everybody likes The Notebook.
Rom-coms are predictable and dumb. I mean, they can be enjoyable if they are funny, which like some actors can do. I've seen funny rom-coms, I'm not gonna deny that. But like, they're all the exact same thing. Like, they can be funny, but like, they all end the exact same way. Here, I can explain a rom-com to you. I can explain every single rom-com to you in a minute here. Let me go. Boy meets girl. He gets girl. Girl finds out thing. Girl leaves guy. Guy does big thing. Gets girl back. End of rom-com. I just explained every single fucking rom-com in a nutshell.
Everybody likes Beyonce. It's just a fact.
Why do you think women?
Beyonce fucking sucks.
Sit around and talk about men in movies.
When y'all easily just sit around and talk about boobs.
Wait, I'm sorry, I missed that one.
Everybody likes Beyonce. It's just a fact.
Why do you make women sit around and talk about
men? Why do we make women sit around and talk about men?
Men in movies.
In movies? We make them? Do we? I don't. I remember going downstairs over the cattle prod and being like, "All right, ladies, get in the corner. It's talk about men time."
So you just sit around and talk about boobs for hours.
Why do you automatically?
I don't understand how that was related. They were like, "Since you make us do this, well, but you do this," and I was like, "Yeah, that doesn't." Also, I don't know a lot of people that can just do that. Like, that's just kind of weird. I don't know a single person, honestly, I can just sit around and talk about nothing but tits for hours. Like, don't get me wrong, I have heard guys like, oh yeah, tits, they're cool, I guess. I'm like, yeah, sure.
Automatically assume that you won't like TV or movies that star a female.
Why are you surprised?
Well, TV and movies, it depends on what it is, but like, there's so much to break down that one, especially comedy type things, because from what I've seen, if someone asked me to name a funny male comedian, I could be going on for hours. Jerry Seinfeld, like Chris Rock, I'm trying to think of one guy's name, but I can't think of it right now. John Mulaney. That's the guy's name I'm trying to think of. He's a great comedian, love of stuff. And then there's like, I could go on all that about funny male comedians, but if someone asked me to name a funny female comedian, I cannot name a single one. I've tried to watch multiple. I have not found any of them funny, because the thing is that guys find guy humor funny, girls find girl humor funny. It's very different because humor has to be a relatable. That's where humor starts and comes from. It comes from a place where you can like, oh yeah, I know that feeling. But like, when a comedian goes, you know, because vagina, guys are gonna laugh at that because it's like, they don't have vagina. So it's like the same thing for women. If a guy makes a joke like, because penis, all the men might find that funny, But the girls are gonna be like, but I don't have penis. I know, I relate. So it's like the same thing there.
Guys, when women are funny.
I'm probably funnier.
That is not a real statement. I'm probably funnier than you. Anyone who works for BuzzFeed is...
The first comment is amazing.
These comments are amazing. We don't talk about boobs for hours. We talk about Trek. Why do men talk about boobs for hours? Me and the boys. Does Lightning McQueen have car insurance or life insurance? I'm probably funnier than you. The funniest thing she has ever said. Oh. Yeah, no, you're not, though. Like, I'm not even saying I'm a funny person, but, like, anyone who works for BuzzFeed doesn't have a sense of humor.
Why do you think that we're obsessed with you when we hook up?
9 times out of 10, I just want you to leave, too. I'm busy. I got shit to do.
What?
That's very weird. I mean, all right, I guess.
I can't sleep with as many people as I want to without being judged. When men do it, they're congratulating.
Why?
They're what? No, but it's the same thing for men as it is for women. Like, no man is gonna be like, oh, you slept with 17 other men this week? Alright, sounds good. Well, let's do it. But, like, a woman isn't gonna be like, oh, well, what's that? You fucked 21 other bitches this week? Alright, sounds good. Let's fuck. It's the same thing. Like, there is no difference there. I don't know what you're on about.
Why do you consider a woman a tease if she doesn't sleep with you after 3 dates, but a slut if she sleeps with you on the first date?
In what world does no...
What? That was just random. I don't know a single person who's ever said that ever.
I mean, yes.
No means no.
Oh, God. Did they just say...
In what world does no mean yes?
Everything hurts. Life is pain. Oh my God. Random fucking rape reference for no fucking reason at all.
No means no.
Why do you say that women are too emotional to be leaders,
then justify catcalling by saying men just can't control themselves?
What?
Those things were very unrelated. First off, women are definitely more emotional than men because they even mention later on in this episode, in this thing, why do men conceal their emotions? It's like, you're as emotional as us, but you're not. Because, you know, toxic masculinity, and you have to make several million points on this stuff, and they don't have to make sense together. They just have to make the tiniest a little bit of sense to some flat earther who is smoking his own organs.
I do think that just because you're nice to me, I owe you my body.
What?
Nice guys. Those are not good examples of men, just in general. Don't. That's like me being like. So, like, I don't know. Why do you. I want to stab me after I sleep with you. Oh, because that's just a small minority of the people that are out there? No. That's, oh my God, that's so fucking dumb, though. But, like, nice guys are very... They're not, like, we don't associate with them. They are not of our gender. They're their own separate gender over there. We're not in with them.
Why would you ever send an unsolicited dick pic?
I don't know, but, like, that's... They're all just, like, so specific. Like, I don't know a single person who has done, like, pretty much anything on here. All without my head. except for like the, oh god, Jesus Christ, I already see what this one's called and I hate it. Communal spaces, like, let's get into this.
Why do you feel like it's okay to harass women or make offensive comments about women, but when somebody does it to your sister, it's not okay?
How does it...
Because, I mean, a lot of men find a derogatory humor funny, so they're probably joking around, because that is how I know me and a lot of other people I know, like, joke around with each other. Humor like that, where it... The thing about humor is, if you can't laugh at yourself, people can't laugh at you. So, if you can't learn to take a joke about yourself, you're not gonna be funny. And I thought you were so much funnier than me.
How does it feel to interrupt me when I'm in the middle of making a point during a meeting?
Why do you have...
Oh my god. Manterruption. And I know they're gonna talk about man-spreading, too. Like, oh my god, it's so dumb. Just put man in front of something, and then all of a sudden it's negative. Yes, yes, yes. Next, it was like Man Hitler, because, you know, Hitler wasn't bad enough. I mean, it has to be called Man Hitler. Just so we all know that Hitler was indeed a man and not a woman.
You have to sit with your legs so wide open.
I said it was coming up. Men have these little things called balls that really fucking hurt if you crush them.
Get that you have balls, but I don't skip.
You obviously don't, and don't even say what I know you're gonna say, because it is very different, because they don't hurt like all hell when your arms, when you like push them up against each other with your arms.
I'm around with my arms wide open to make room for my boobs.
Oh god, no.
Why are women perceived as the weaker sex?
Bruh.
Even though we literally birth you.
Because that's what your body's built for, and they're going off of statistics. Like, statistically speaking, you are, like, the weaker sex. Like, that is just a literal fact.
Like, watermelons through, like, this.
Why is it so bad to show your emotions?
It means you're...
But I thought men were just as emotional as women all the time, right?
Human.
Why are you always trying to prove your masculinity?
Why the f*** isn't it lady like to cuss? When do words get gender?
Why is it your...
It's not... It's not ladylike. It's just... It's kind of frowned upon because, you know... Yelling curse words pretty much anywhere is just, like, frowned upon just in general, no matter what your gender is.
First instinct to doubt women who have been sexually violated or raped.
Because, sadly, there are a lot of false cases and stuff like that, which is disgusting. People just trying to get some quick cash. And, honestly, it's very upsetting that happens in our world, but that sadly, thanks to... some incel chuckle fucks, that is a thing.
Wait, why do you assume a woman's angry because she's on her period?
Why do you...
Because you are.
Why do you think women that wear makeup are false advertising?
Because... It's like...
You can say the same thing about your dick size. Why?
What, huh? I don't, like, put, like, some kind of... blush on my dick and then make it look like six times as big. Nothing. There is nothing for that. Like, there is literally nothing for that. I don't even get that one.
Why isn't it weird that there's a bunch of old white men sitting in a room making legislation about what I can and can't do with my body?
Because that's kind of how... I can't even... It's kind of how, you know, the world works. Like, this isn't a new thing. It's not like this was, you know, a new feature to, you know, modern day society that's been around since, like, the dawn of time. Like, even, like, the Greeks had a government.
Do you have a coochie?
Why are straight guys so obsessed with lesbians?
I don't know. I mean, it's okay. Think about it this way. I watched a Shoe on Head video, and they made a great way of explaining this. Okay, you have a chocolate bar. I really like chocolate bars. That's a good chocolate bar. Well, do you want another chocolate bar? Yeah. Now you have two of the things that you really, really like.
Does it feel to get kicked in the balls?
Do you ever get tired?
It hurts.
Trying to be manly all the time.
No, it's just I don't even know why that's a question.
Why are you so afraid of gender equality?
Why do I deserve to be paid less than you?
Wage gap. Just watch Shoe on Head video. I'll link it in the description. I'm not going into the wage gap.
In what world does 77 cents equal a
shut up
dollar?
In what world does 68 cents
shut up
equal a dollar?
How is that fair?
Why are you intimidated by a woman who makes more money than you? That's awesome.
You were just saying earlier in this a video that like men should, or it might have been a different thing, but I know one of these things that they were saying, like, men need to provide for women or something, otherwise they're, like, pussies and, like, failures.
More money! Why are opinionated women seen as bitches?
With?
Because they normally, I come off as them, because I know a lot of the people I know who are very opinionated force their opinions into every single topic. Like, we can go from, like, we'll be talking about cake, and they'll be like, so, you want to hear about the patriarchy?
Opinionated men are seen as bosses.
I don't think that's real, but okay.
Why aren't you speaking up when you hear your male friends behind closed doors make jokes that are offensive to women?
Because they're jokes. You said it yourself. It's a joke. And I thought you, once again, I thought you were the funny one. I thought you could take jokes, right? I thought you were great at with jokes.
Why are you so afraid of recognizing your own privilege?
Shut up.
Doesn't mean you're
shut
a
up
bad person. Just recognize.
Shut up. Shut up. Yeah, that was hard. That was hard to watch. I really can't do that. Oh god. Anyways, That genuinely hurt every part of my body. Oh my god, that was terrible. Anyways, this was another good episode, if I do say so myself. So have a good day, my giggity giggity giggity.